Hello friends, today we shall know regarding the important details regarding the one of the greatest human being, great Guru, Sadguru, that is Jaggi Vasudev, popularly known as Sadguru. What are the aspects, what are the life incidents that are happening according with the Vedic astrology, let us see now. Many of the people simply believing that, simply they are telling that Vedic astrology is nonsense, and simply those who are not having confidence and those who are not having any work to do, only do and observe this astrology. So fact is not like that, friends. The astrology is not from today it was happened. It was happened since thousands of years back. It was written, and it was that the godly science was preached. So such a good astrology is nowadays becoming a matter of laughter. So I would like to tell you the fact that astrology is not a fact of love. Astrology is a matter of fact. Yes, friends, it is what I am telling is right. The astrology is a matter of fact. I'll go on telling you what are the factors that tells these things. So let us see now. Firstly, I'll tell you about you see, this is the natal chart of Sadguru's natal chart, and this is an ascendant. I think some of you are in a very basic stage, and some of you are in the advanced stage, some of you are in the middle stage. I would like to convey this astrology for all three layers, all three categories. So firstly, I have to tell you regarding what is ascendant. Ascendant means that is the first house from which the calculation of houses is started. Here in this case, you see this one is a Rishabh or Taurus sign. That is the first sign of his natal chart. That first sign indicate his physical nature, that personality, and something else. The second house is a wealth, third house is a communication, younger brother, fourth house is considered as a vehicle, land, mother, and fifth house is concerned as intelligence and children and entertainment. Sixth house is concerned as a loan, debt, and enemies. Seventh house considered as a partner. Eighth house is considered as a the house of death, also some people are telling that. And next, ninth house is the house of fortune, ninth house. And tenth house is the house of karma. 11th house is the house of gains, and 12th house is the house of losses. So these are the important things one has to know by the natal chart. And in this first house, I am telling you, that is the Taurus sign, that is his first sign. And according to Vedic principles, the first lord must be placed in a Kendra or Trikonas. Which are the Kendra and Trikonas? Kendra and Trikonas are the first, fourth, seventh, and tenth house are Kendra, and one, five, and ninth house are called as the Trikona houses. If the ascendant lord, that means first house lord sitting in any one of these house, are forming any relationship with any one of the house, any one of these houses, means then is considered as a fortunate. Here you see, in the matter of Sadguru Vasudev, Jaggi Vasudev or Sadguru is the ascendant lord, is sitting in the fifth house. Ascendant lord sitting in the fifth house, that fifth is a Trikona house, and also the Jupiter, the Deva Guru Jupiter, are very auspicious planet in the astrology, is sitting with him. That is the one of the greatest thing one can say, that he will become a greatest guru or the person who spreads the knowledge. So next one, you see now, next one. You see, next important thing you have to know is the ascendant lord is sitting in the fifth house. Okay, fifth house is what we call Venus. For the Venus, fifth house is a debilitated sign, and it is a totally unfortunate sign for the misfortunate sign for the Venus. But here, what saved it means it is in the fifth house, first one, and the fifth lord, that is Mercury, who is sitting in the fourth house. Fourth house is a house of comforts, house of the land and comforts, happiness. So that fifth lord in the fourth house, the house of happiness, house of luxury, house of fulfillment, house of mother, house of our happiness. So all this fifth lord is sitting in a well placed. That is why he is considered as a fortunate. So next, let us see now, and you see there, these are the important factors, and much more things I have to tell you. That is the seventh house, the Saturn is sitting in the seventh house. So seventh house, wherever that seventh house, whichever the planets that seventh house is sitting, means the person will work for it. The Saturn, wherever, in whichever sign he is sitting for, so he will work for that. For example, Saturn is sitting in the seventh house. Seventh house is the house of house of the partner, are the people whom we are contacting with. So this person, this Sadhguru, is always willing to help out the people, and willing to give the direction to the people, and all those things will happen. So that is what the seventh house and the Saturn indicate. And Ketu in the 11th house, it is very good placement for the Ketu, for the Moksha Karaka. So 12th house is a Moksha house, and Ketu is also Karaka for 12th house. So is a the person who is getting the Moksha in this life. So next one, the Ascendant Lord in the 5th house. But you see, the Moon is a third lord. Moon is a karaka for the mind. So that mind, the karaka of mind, is sitting in the 8th house, one of the Pacha house. That is why you see, his mind is always going with what? That 8th house is a transformation. 8th house is a transformation, and 8th house is a exploration. The person, the 8th house is completely considered as a black, and the person is always willing to explore. So here very much darkness is there, means you would like to explore more. What is there in the darkness? Like that person is always going to explore the things. So the next important thing, let me see now, is life events. Let me see. I'll tell you. See, this is facts about Sadhguru's. Sadhguru born on the 3rd September 1957 and got degree in 1982. And started in his Isha Foundation in 1992. And in Inner Engineering, his book was published in 2016. So that is one fact. And World Economic Forum, he spoke in the World Economic Forum. It's not a matter of joke. There he was talked in the World Economic Forum in 2007, 2017, and 2020. So that indicates, that tells that how much big is, and how much big entrepreneur and he is. So that is another thing. And one more thing that is very, very, very important is he got a spiritual enlightenment on the 23rd September 1982. And in the 1989, his mother was passed, and in the 1990s, daughter was born. And one more event was happening. 1997, he lost his wife. So, can we check these events, which whether they are complement with birth chart or natal chart? Sure, let us see now. See this. Next, you see in the, there in the 1982, he got a degree, and in the same age, that is in the 23rd September 1982, he was got enlightenment. So I already told you that, you see, in his natal chart also, in his natal chart, you see, there, 8th Lord, Jupiter, sitting in the ascendant Lord. So, this person is always willing to explore. He is not satisfied with whatever. So, simply, he is always searching what is life, what is... So, he is always, his mind is always involved in a... knowing mystical things, mystics. Yes, eighth house is concerned with mystics. Mystics means the things which cannot come to the radical, cannot easily understand those things. That is what. So that's why only we call him as a mystic. Mystic means the person who know the things which the common man cannot know, such things. So his ascendant Lord is associated with the 8th house, and 8th Lord is in the 5th house. That made him to explore more, and that made him a person who is looking for the solutions for the problems which man is facing. So next, let us see now, what are the vertical dashas, whether they are having any dashas, they are assisting this. Let me see now. You see here, you see here in the 1997 up to 1997, he was having a Venus dasha. During that period, his education, elementary education was happening good. And you see that education of him is not that good. Why? Because he is ascendant Lord. The Venus is in ascendant Lord. And his ascendant Lord is placed with the 8th Lord. So that is why it is one of the bad combination. So that person is not interested to have a formal education. He is not interested in getting formal education. He would not like to get the education everybody is getting. He want the education that none of us are not having. That is why he is been a very different in his academics. Means he was not at all interested in academic pursuits, and he was very much interested in outside in the environment, exploring more, and in the looking after the birds, animals, snakes, like that. So next, in the 1977, up to 1977, he was having that Sun Dasha. Sun, let us see where Sun placed. See, Sun placed in the 4th house. So since from 71 to 77, he was having a greatest pleasure in his life. He enjoyed a lot. So afterwards, from 1977 to 1987, you see, that is Moon Dasha. You see, this is a very important factor you have to keep in your mind, friends. So Moon is placed in the 8th house. Moon is placed in the 8th house. 8th house is considered as one of the most malefic house in the astrology. But this is also totally change of his life has happened. He used to say, from 1977 to 1987, his life was becoming lot of changes. Means to say, he was becoming a, what you call, upset with everything, and he would like to spend much of his time there in the other forms. So he is become, his mystical experience happened during this period only. I hope you understood, and remaining I'll tell you in the next video. Thank you, friends. Thank you very much for watching my video. Thank you.